Welcome to the Storm Watch 9 webcast and your first day of September. I am meteorologist Kevin Skarupa. Certainly the record heat continues out there for us. Concord, Portsmouth expected to eclipse record highs out there this afternoon. We are shooting for 93 and 92 degrees. And these records go back quite a few decades. We are expecting a 96-degree reading in Concord and right around 93 before a sea breeze kicks in out in Portsmouth this afternoon. Here's a look at future cast. Again, sunshine. There is even a heat warning or a heat advisory posted for a good portion of the southern half of the state with a heat index expected to approach 100 in a few spots for a brief time this afternoon. It will be clear skies out there tonight. Temperatures will drop back into the 60s to near 70. For tomorrow, there could be a stray thundershower around in northern areas late in the day. Otherwise, it will be another hot day with temperatures upper 80s in the north country to lower half of the 90s in southern areas. And this front eventually slides close enough that it takes, as you can see, these clouds here that are starting to blow off from Earl to our south, moving up the eastern seaboard, slowly pushing that out to sea. And it looks like the main timeline and best chance for us to get the rainfall, either from that or from the front out to our west, will be very late Friday afternoon and Friday evening, while it'll gradually push away during the day on Saturday, along with the wind lingering around Friday night and early Saturday. So 87 to 98, the temperature range through the afternoon from north to south, 85 to 95 tomorrow. And again, that similar humidity level will be out there. We'll drop into the 80s on Friday, but it should be a little bit more humid right ahead of that front. And again, that front is what steers eventually Earl from its northern movement up toward the Carolina shoreline to eventually northeast and just to our south, south of the Cape and south of Long Island. You can clearly see the front here back through the Great Lakes, and that slides through, leading us to a more pleasant set of circumstances in time for the weekend. But we're going to have a close brush with a hurricane before we get there. And it continues to be a very strong hurricane at the present time. And you can see it here gradually evolving, a very good center of circulation. A lot of thunderstorm activity around it on its movement to the northwest right now. Top winds have it as a Category 3 hurricane with winds of 125 miles an hour. Movement continues at 15 to 20 miles an hour, eventually putting it just off the North Carolina shoreline as we work our way through tomorrow afternoon. Then it continues northward, anywhere just to the east of areas of the mid-Atlantic states and New Jersey. And then the cold front, which is making its way into our area tomorrow afternoon, eventually gives it a little bit of a push-shove to the north and east. So that's one of the players. The other is the huge Bermuda High offshore that has been winding this thing around it over the last couple of days in a clockwise fashion. And it is really only a matter of 50 to 100 miles one way or another to exactly the effects we see here in the Granite State being on the northwestern fringes and the brush with this hurricane. But most of the computer maps the last few days and even now have it about 100 miles offshore of Cape Cod. That puts us with a glancing blow here in southern portions of the state and probably more rainfall coming from the front back out to our west. Notice here, as you get about 2 days away from an approaching hurricane, there is still a fairly large cone of error, average error. And so that cone still remains aboard portions of the Granite State now and will continue to give us that chance, at least, of some rainfall from it and some wind from it. But it does look like the heaviest portion of this will stay to our southeast as it stands now. So our forecast as we work our way through the afternoon, 87 to 98, heat index nearing 100 in some southern areas, heat wave day 4, and it looks like we'll have a day 5 tomorrow. Seas have been kicking up between 3 and 5 feet. Those will only increase after Earl moves by Friday night and into the day Saturday. So if you are headed to the beaches this weekend, it will be cooler, but there is going to be some high surf and some riptide issues to contend with along the eastern-facing beaches and even in the southern-facing beaches across New England.